Gary here, and welcome to episode number 23 of Let's Play of East, the Oath in Felghana on the PC. In the last episode, we climbed the clock tower, or I assume climbed the clock tower. You used the key to get in, then climbed up. So, got a save point and a door into a place we've not been to yet. I'm going to hazard a guess we've got cutscene and or boss time. So, there goes the music. Ah, McGuire, you fool. Nope, you've made your bed. Because it's time to take a nice long nap in it. Oh, okay. What part of demon did you think would make it, like, you know, good to you, like, you know, easy to use? And then I ended up killing them all. Okay. Well, if that's the truth, then why did it happen? Yeah. Perhaps not. I do like this, that you kind of do empathise with him, even though he's being a bit of a tool about it, Chester. But yeah. Oh dear. But look at my shiny new suit of armour and everything. Isn't it cool? Right? It does when you just turn everyone into monsters. He didn't cut him down, he just kind of stabbed him a bit, but yeah. Okay, so now it's round two with Chester. He's looking pretty tough. He's got some big attacks going. Ah, shout for those. We're picking at him here, I guess. Ow, okay. Yeah, no, he's getting really bad now. I mean, it did say vengeful, so that stands for reason, I guess, but yeah. It's not fair. He's got like 3,000 HP and I've got 300. I'm actually technically doing better than him, I think, at the moment. But, in terms of damage done, but yeah. Okay, he's got a shield and a nasty. Yeah. Ow. Probably make more use of this, actually. Get my guard up a bit. Ugh. Come on. Ugh. Get him. Out of the way. Just keep jumping everywhere. Right. Oh, still caught us. Right. Ow. I'm gonna be dead soon, aren't I? Yeah, very soon. Immediately. Okay. Damn it, Chester. I'm already dead. Okay, let's try this again. So, he will use that attack. He will spam the... Ooh, okay. I missed my gap. Ah, see, if he does that one, you got to stay away from him. Which he's doing every time I get close to him at the moment. I'll just... Oh. Right, that one leaves him open a little bit. Ugh. See, those ones are the easiest ones to probably... There. I'm getting hit by some of the easy... Those ones should be... See? Those ones should be easy dodgeable, because you can see them coming. Unlike that one, which is a bit more... Come on. Doing worse this time I did last time, I think. Ow. Okay, that did no damage whatsoever. That also did no damage. It's got to be sword, I guess. Sword on sword. Come on. He is actually doing... No, he's not. He's still technically not, but... He's definitely doing better than he did last time. Yeah, I'll do it. Okay. Once again, Get back. Oh, out the way. Ugh, see, that's annoying. If you go in a certain way, like, in that case there, I had nowhere to go. Just get out of the way of that. I think I just avoided that there. Some of the attacks you just have open afterwards, but you've got to be close enough in the first place to have either taken the damage, basically. Oh, see, that's not one of them, though. Not that one either. It's the one with the this one. Yeah, leaves himself open for a little bit and you can get a couple of hits in there. So I guess you've just got to be take your time, bide your time. That one you stay the hell away from. Right, that one is open, get a couple of hits in. Right, run away. Oh, watch out for those. See, it's timing that. So also you get hit by that one. You haven't got time to then respond to it. There we go. Right, run away. I'm sure he's going to have some more attacks once you get to halfway through as well, which is annoying. If and when. See, I timed that wrong. Just managed to get a couple of attacks in there, though. Ah, just got away with that. Oh, okay, see, now he's countering with that one. Ow, that was silly, that was an avoidable one. That was also should have been avoidable. Ugh. Not doing much better than I did when I just went and attacked him randomly here. See, because now he's still hitting me with these. And he's got his attack still himself. Yeah. God damn it, Chester, you suck. Right, get in there quickly. Ah, see, yeah, he's still got that counter. I can't even attack him head on with that. Moment. So now I'm attacking him head on, he's doing that. Too close. Run away. Isn't good. Sorry, sneezing. Hay fever this time of year. I'm gonna restart this fight because I've just lost my everything. Just go on then. Come on. There we go. Right. See if I can do this again without kind of losing my train of thought halfway through. See, I've got to watch out for that one. I don't know how to avoid it. It's when they're going for the head on. Okay. Ow. Right. I've got to make better use of that guard, actually. That might help. Didn't go too badly that actually, but let's work on that. So switch on to him. Ugh. Okay, that could have gone better. A lot better. Problem is I'm scaring myself off getting too close into him. Apart from its predetermined times, because he has that attack. Not that attack, sorry, I thought it was going to be the other one. The area of, like, you know, where he just kind of has a ray of light coming out from him. Not that one, even. Another one. He has so many of them. Right. Not that one either. Nope, not that one either. Come on. We're getting there, slowly. That one. Just starting to piss me off. Get one attack, get the hell away. That's it, that's how you avoid that one. Stop it, stop it. See, I've now gotten to the point where he's doing new stupid stuff. Well, I can't even keep up with him. But he's got that still going on. So, ow. Yeah, so I get it, you can be really fast. Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there very slowly, but we're getting there. Like I say, we have to learn a new set of abilities the second time round. Or changes or whatever, you know, reactions to move sets. And just try and... Oh, see, I should have used guard there. I'm there. Yeah. Come on. Yeah. You suck. Right, this is a write-off already. How do you not quite be so offensive, I guess? I mean, we're getting there slowly, just not very well successfully. Yeah. Ow. I'm kind of, see, I've kind of written this one off. I'm just playing with some tactics here, so can I dodge these to, like, a bit? Maybe get a run in at him while he's doing these basic attacks. So, like, if he does that. No. See, that was stupid. It's just. There, that's how you do it. You don't try and weave between the two of them, you try and weave between the two sets of them. So go that way for that one, that way for that one, and you're almost there. Of course, then he decides to counter with that. And that, and that. Damn it, Chester, you suck. You'd really suck. I can't do any elemental damage to him, which is really annoying. Yeah. This is annoying because his, like, it's pure magic. This is what he's using, basically. He's supposed to be a knight, but there's no real. He does that, but that's it. Like, if it was just straight fight, I'd probably beat him. But his entire offense is based on these bloody lightning spells. There we go. Come on. What are you going to do? That one. I tipped twice by it that time. Right, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to go and get my gear sorted out actually a little bit. So, I'm just going to throw this fight and I'll meet you back at Redmond. Right, so we will head back in here and try and get some of this gear tempered. So, how are we looking? Yeah. So let's have a look. I can afford that. But that's it. I think that's probably still the best thing to do, but yeah, we'll do that for now. And the other thing I'm going to do before I try going any further, talking about leveling up again, is I'm going to have one more run at that little area, because I've got another few levels again since the last time I was there, is have a run at that bit in the Ilburn's Ruins. So if I can do it, basically what I want to be able to do, kind of, is just make it, you know, if I can get leveled up quickly and easily, I want to do that. I'm all about that. So just head down through here. One hit kills at this point for these guys. Get a little bit of Reval, which might be useful. That's the reason I'm kind of coming through and killing these. They actually drop more Reval than a lot of enemies generally do. Might be to do with the fact that you're killing them quickly, I'm not sure, but yeah. If I head back down here. Oh, took some damage there. Oh no. Stop being sarcastic, I probably will end up getting hit by some sort of death attack or something. But it was out here. And there we go. So yeah, just come here. It was up in here. Now let us just try. I'm gonna equip fire to give us a rough indicator. Because what you end up with, these are doable now, potentially. We were doing one damage to these. Now this is probably still gonna be difficult, but doable. Possibly. It's just about keeping your tactics together, I guess. And not getting too many of them. No, I'm gonna die, Anna. Yeah, let's go back outside and try and heal up. So let's drop some stuff, please. Come on, guys, be good. There we go. I can get myself fully healed up here. This would be funny, actually, but I can always go back to the save point as well, but just making my way through here. Actually, there, we can move that. Let's try this one instead. Pulling that area is actually, I could try actually just charging through and try and get in a position where you can get a better sort of tactical fight than in a long narrow corridor. Might be worth a look. So again, I'm going to save up and yeah, we're nearly back, nearly just up here. Right, actually I'm just going to make sure I'm saved there as well, so I don't lose all of my new gear and whatnot. All of it. My leveled up sword. And I'm just going to run past these this time. Just don't bother at all. There we go. So past him. And let's see if we can just charge up through here in another area. So, okay, let's try and do a better job than that. Okay. Well, that wasn't what I was planning on doing, but sure. Spirit Cape, what's that do? Is that my heal item? Yes, excellent. Right, I was actually wanting that as well. So, what I'm going to try and do is get back out of here in one piece. Now, can I do anything with these? With that? Not a lot, really, actually. Sorry, get back. Basically full health again. Although I've got my spirit cape, I can just kind of stand still, I think, and just heal. Maybe not if I'm in a fight, thinking about it. The idea is it should, yeah, only when resting. So if I stand still, there we go, back to full health. Right, let's try taking these on. I'm gonna try and get one aggroed and just do this to him, if I can. Right, I know these are tough. They're supposed to be tough, I guess. But, yeah. Nope. So if I can get some leveling up going on, that would be superb. That's really what I'm after here. Yeah. There's one down. Oh, these have that. They're going to come back to life, aren't they? You didn't actually die. Meh. Ah, that actually was, couldn't have been timed any better there. No. Right, yeah, it's the, you need an item to make sure they stay dead, basically. Actually, I got it. No. Oh, well. Let's have a look. What else can we do? I guess we go back to the castle and just... Is that where we're at the keep? Sorry. Might go back downstairs and have a bit of a level up again, just try and get myself a little bit tougher, toughened up. So if I can get myself to whatever the next level is, that would be, again, great. What level am I now? 42. Yeah, so... Ow. Dude. I'm aware it's kind of mitigating the need for skill, but that's... I think it's still a valid battle plan. So yeah, let's do that. Never claimed to be the most skillful player in the world. Even in the town probably, but yeah. Actually, we're not leveling up that quickly. I was hoping that in the room full of these guys, we should be doing pretty well, but no, we're not. So we got some nice items back off it, but. In terms of actual sort of flying up through the levels, I was hoping to do a lot better. I mean, I think if I can get at least this build, like, you get, when your hit percentage goes up, your EXP rate goes up as well. So if I can get that up a bit, that would be great, because that should make these twice. Basically, I think it plateaus at 99. It doesn't plateau, just stops in 99. But that means it's basically double XP you're getting for the fight, so that's always good. So I can kill two of these. There, you can see that was the biggest jump there, actually. Ow. Okay, that was silly. Come on. There we go. I think you've got to be kind of fast about it, so they keep maintain that gauge. So if I just dip in and out of here, that should keep it up. There we go, yeah. So we're still at 99. Now, this is how I kind of got myself quickly leveled up to 41 before the last boss fight, where I was like, oh, this is going quite well, actually, I'll just keep doing this. I was just running in and out of the room, like dipping in and out, sort of, to try and keep them. Ow, damn it. Let me say that this one here, I can see me end up needing to go and heal, which will probably kill the bar, but yeah, definitely gonna need to heal at some point. Getting sloppy, or just not very good. But actually, I'm saying one more of these should get us leveled up, so if I can quickly not die. There we go. And that's full health again, so I actually don't need to worry about it. That's the good thing about leveling up in this game, at least. It's a free heal. Actually, now I've got my new item, I can heal a little bit. But again, it's just a time constraint. You want to keep it going. Like, you don't want to be standing around waiting for the heal to start. Metaphorically or physically, but yeah, let's just get him taken down. There we go. See, sometimes you get runs of getting the item drops, like the herbs from an item drop anyway, so also just need to watch what I'm doing, not trying to stick to the tactic which is just jump on the face. Because that's clearly how this is, like, the easiest way, as that I've seen, to take these on, is just to try and stun them. Because if their attacks are big, heavy-hitting attacks, they look like the type of dude who would do that, obviously. There we go, another one. So, yeah, so this will be it. What I'm probably going to do is I'll meet you back. I'm going to get myself up to the next level again. It will just be this over and over, but this isn't. I think I've been through here 4 times now while talking about going through here. So I'll do that off-screen. And I'll meet you when I get to level 44. Right, so I've made my way up to level 44 there. I think a cool level should be enough to be useful. And the thing you notice is that I'm a little bit way to the next level as well, because I was trying to collect, I was getting quite a lot of Reval when I was on, like Reval or while I was on. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to head back down to the bridge, Redmond, go to see Adonis, because I think it was 350, which is why I wanted to get my, might be 300, but I wanted to make sure I had enough for upgrading both of my armors, hopefully. I was only 300, okay, I maybe wasted a little bit of time there then, but I can get these two leveled up. Perfect. Right, so we've got max level gear. We have a couple more levels. And actually, I can do it from here. I was, again, every time, forget. I can just do it from anywhere. Head back to the keep. I'm going to save up, and then we're going to have another word with Chester. So what I'll do is I'll just meet you, probably be... where was that? Oh, that was me trying that. Yeah, I'll meet you after the cutscene. We'll start the fight again. So... a bit better prepared now, hopefully. Yeah, he's doing a lot less damage at least, that's a start. That was part of the goal here. I also need to just not be terrible. That's always a big plus, if I can do that. That's it. Oh, actually doing that counter still. So we're doing more damage when we do hit him, and taking less damage when he hits me. So, fingers crossed I can do something with this. I've got a feeling I'm still going to fail the first time here. Just because he is proving to be a bit of a swine. And that was the wrong one, I wanted that one on. Ouch. Just get a couple of attacks in there quickly. Yeah. There we go, right, get the... Okay, you win. There we go, missed one of those at least, that's a start. Out the way of that one. He's really not relatively good at this sword fighting bit though. I've hit him for like 10 times damage than he is hitting me. So yeah, just do that. I should have avoided that one there really. Right, now he's starting to go scatty, like all over the shop, jumping around. So that must be at half health. He changes his tactics up. There we go. Managed to nail that as well. Ow. Yeah, you can move quickly still. Now I'm just going to wait for you to do that linear attack, whichever you call it, but I know which one I mean. Yeah, go on, keep going. Oh, okay. Right, let him hit me a bit. Not that one. This one. Ah. God, he's just annoying. I should try and just go for him a bit. Still doing okay for HP, actually. So I'm not actually getting him any attacks in him at all, because he's not holding still long enough to let me get anywhere near him. There we go. That wasn't bad. There we go, get a few in here. That's better. Just come down from on high onto him, kind of. Ugh. If I just kick him in the face a couple more times, that'll just do it, I think. Let's go for it. Just flail wildly in his direction. That'll do. Woohoo! Ah, leveling up, my old friend. I beat you last time as well, didn't I? Yeah, McGuire's had enough of this. He's just having a... Well, what do you expect was going to happen, you fool? Come on. I should tell you what. I'm going to wrap it up there. I'm going to head back to the save point and save, and we'll see. I don't want it to be double boss time, basically. Because that locks me in. So let's do that. And in the next episode, we will chase them up the stairs and see what's going on in the actual clock tower. So until then, thank you very much for watching. Take care of yourself and have a good day. Goodbye.